Everyone needs compassion, a love that's never failing. Let mercy fall on me. Everyone needs forgiveness, the kindness of a savior.
Welcome everyone to Carolina Global Revival. I'm Robin Mowbray, your host. Thank you for joining us today. And I would like to thank Nashcombe Realty for being our sponsor today. And today we have Jodi Aiken and Carolyn Reese in the house, and they're going to talk about Hope-Filled Conversations, their podcast. But first, let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, thank you so much for who you are, that you love us so much. We thank you for the gift of encouragement and hope that your word brings to us as we read and study your word. Lord, please lead, guide, and direct us during this time we have today. We give you all the praise and honor and glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we ask it. Amen. Amen. Well, whatever subject we talk about in our program, we like to go to the Word of God and see what the Lord has to say about it. And my topic this day was hope, because we all need hope. This is a new year, 2022, and we believe it's going to be a great year. In Ephesians 1:18, I pray that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened in order that you may know the hope to which he has called you, the riches of his glorious inheritance in his holy people. And Romans 15:13, love that. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope, amen, and the power of the Holy Spirit. And in Hebrews 10:23, let us hold unswervingly to the hope we profess, for he who promises is faithful. And he is so faithful. We are just so tickled to have in the house Carolyn Reese and Jodi Aiken. And let me introduce you properly, Jodi. Jodi, you are the wife of Pastor Chris Aiken of Inglewood Baptist Church, and you're a wife and a mother of two grown married children, sons, and you have a grandchild, right?
I have a almost 2-year-old and one on the way.
Yay, that's so exciting. And you graduated from Pensacola State College in business administration, and you have a great podcast, Pennies in My Path, and you're also a women's speaker and blogger, but most importantly, you're a co-host with Carolyn of Hope-Filled Conversations, right?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
And Carolyn Reese, you are a graduate of Liberty University in education. You also have your master's from Liberty in education. You're married to Jordan Reese, who's another pastor of discipleship at Inglewood Baptist Church, and you're in the process of adopting a fourth child.
Our fourth child, we have three.
Oh, that's exciting. Yeah. And young children. So you are so busy. And also, most importantly, you're co-host with Jodi of Hope-Filled Conversations podcast.
That's
so
right.
Tell us, how was the Hope-Filled Conversation podcast birthed, and when did you guys begin, and how did it transition?
It was definitely a God thing.
Yeah, it was definitely a God thing.
And a good thing from the pandemic, I think.
Right. Yeah, it started in 2020 around April out of a need and a desire to bring our women, to connect our women, because if you remember, in the throes of it, when it began, so many people, we were hunkered down at home. And so, the women's director at our church said, hey, you know, what about doing something for our women? And so I called Carolyn, and he was actually, God was working on her heart at the same time. And so Hope-Filled Conversations was birthed.
Yeah.
But we started off with Zoom. Do you want me to show some pictures with that?
Yes, we have some pictures. Let's do it.
From the early days.
Hope-Filled Conversations, that's our logo.
Yeah.
So that when you're looking us up, you can see that.
Yeah.
Let's see, what else have we got? Carolyn's at her home, and
I was in my children's playroom, set up with my little computer on the table,
and I was in my dining room. And so we would videotape when we did it live. We had women join us on Zoom, and then offered the recordings to go with that. And so that's how that began. And then we were like, you know what? We want to get out from the camera.
Mm-hmm.
And we found a spot in the beginning. It felt a little bit like the closet, kind of threw some things together to start that off with. And then ultimately, God provided a more professional space, not just for us, but for some other people to utilize that. And we are actually now in around our 77th episode of Hope-Filled Conversations.
That is great.
That is so.
Did I cover all that?
Yes. It was a sweet time when we were on Zoom. We could see all our ladies' faces
because
we were all at home. But then when schedules started opening up, it was just kind of a good transition time to offer that as a podcast. So,
that is so neat. And ladies, why is it so important to study the Word of God, and how does your podcast make it fun to study the Word?
We love to quote Hebrews 4:12 to ourselves and on our podcast that the Word of God is living and active. And we truly believe that that's why it's so important to study the Word of God. He meets you right where you are in any circumstance that you face. He is right there, and He is faithful every time we open the Word of God. So that's why it's so important to us. You know, and through our podcast, we just hope to fill, just to share that hope that we find in His Word during this time that's not really hope-filled. If you look around the world, it's really hard to find hope. But we know that in the Word of God we find hope, and so that's where
we're. God's given us that joy, and one of the things that draws that joy out of us is when we're in the Word. And there's a quote from Warren Wiersbe that I would like to say
that
I want to read to you guys. He wrote, "The will of God is an important part of a successful Christian life. God wants us to know His will and understand it. God is not a distant dictator who issues orders and never explains. Because we are His friends, we can know what He is doing and why He is doing it. As we study His Word and pray, we discover," and this is the part I love about this, "we discover new and exciting truths about God's will for His people." And I just thought that really just summed it up. Really
it does. Oh, that's very good. That's very good. Well, y'all talk about many different subjects, and you have many different guests on. Can you share some of the things that you have talked about over your last 70-some weeks? You
know? I think we started with who is God, and so we were just talking about the character of God and who He is. We thought that was so foundational to where we wanted to go with our study. But we've done, we spent a summer in Psalm 119, which was one of our favorites to do. We studied the book of Philippians. We've also talked about people in the Bible. Some of my favorites were Daniel, Mary, Sarah, Jonah. Right. We have many others, but
We did questions that need to be answered, and that was one of our favorites this week. I think all of them are favorites.
That was a good one.
It just kind of took things in a little bit of a different direction. We came up with some ways to really dive deep and discover why we believe what we believe. And it was just some questions, like we even tackled the Holy Spirit, the Trinity. Who is the Spirit? Who's the Father? And so we dove into that.
We talked about the Bible. Where did the Bible come from? Why we believe the Bible is true, the Word of God. And so I think it's really a good resource for believers who are just trying to figure out why they believe what they believe, but also for people who are wanting to learn more about Christianity. It just kind of lays it out there for you.
So. And in that, we give scripture references, and so we encourage you to go and take that scripture and dig deeper. So we just kind of set the foundation and just kind of in hopes that you will just take it that a little bit further. And currently, we are publishing some of our interviews with our guests from a Women Called conference that we had, and they're coming into our studio and sharing some of their wisdom through prayer. And so we're focused on the first quarter, our first couple months anyway, on the Hope-Filled Conversations geared toward prayer, and and given some insight of how to pray mm-hmm. and some scriptures and stuff like that yeah. to use as resources.
Yeah. Oh, that's so good. And you've had various, you know, you said mentioned books of the Bible that mm-hmm. you've taken, Daniel and Jonah mm-hmm. and was it Ruth? Did you do several? And then mm-hmm. you have different people to come into the studio that you also, at the beginning, where you say, who do you identify with yes. as your
yeah.
Bible character?
I enjoyed that.
Yeah, it's interesting to hear all the different
ones. Yeah, and even the things before Christmas on hospitality and different traditions,
yes.
that was interesting too.
We had a great guest, Michelle Williams, who just kind of walked us through what she had been learning about biblical
yeah.
hospitality.
That was so good.
It's practical and so encouraging.
Yeah. I'm enjoying all these podcasts, and I think y'all can enjoy it too. And you're going to show us. How do you get there on your on the web? You just go. You can go to Inglewood Baptist Church, or
mm-hmm. you can look under Women's Ministry and Inglewood Baptist Church. We're mm-hmm. also on any podcast platform, so mm-hmm. Apple, Google.
Yeah, and I believe it's Inglewoodbaptist.com/. Hope-filled.
Hope-filled. So that will do it. And mm-hmm. you choose your topics, you just pray, and the Lord gives them to you. And
well, I was going to say we roll the dice.
No. Lots of prayer, lots of discussion. Yeah. A lot of times it comes from our personal Bible study.
Yeah.
The Lord's
mm-hmm.
you know, really speaking to us through a certain passage or about a certain topic. But yeah, yes, a variety of different ways.
Yeah. Yeah. And as we're connecting with the women that God has given us to be able to just kind of rub shoulders with, recognizing what they might be going through, sometimes actually helps guide us and go, you know, what do the listeners need mm-hmm. to hear? Kind of like what you do here, mm-hmm. you know, as you pray through and ask the Lord for discernment in the timing of the year and what's going on in the
mm-hmm.
world
yeah.
and stuff like that. So God uses even that to encourage us and lead us. But I think mostly it is from our time that we're spending with the Lord in the Word, and as He's doing a ministry deep mm-hmm. in us, I think those are the most fun for us, is that when we've like, oh my goodness, God just did a deep work, and I really don't want anybody to know about it, but they're going to know about it.
I know, I was going to say, sometimes we get
sure.
in the studio and we just feel like we're bubbling over because we have
mm-hmm.
so much stuff that the Lord's taught us through, and it just comes spilling out through the
podcast. Because we don't teach or share anything that the Lord's not first done in our lives.
Exactly.
So, while one of our missions and reasons why we're doing is to disciple women, mm-hmm. God in turn really is discipling us and one another. We kind of just naturally disciple one another mm-hmm. because iron sharpens iron.
It does.
And you can never really be sharp enough, you know.
Yes. And, you know, a teacher is doubly blessed because they learn more about their topic than anybody else, you know.
Right.
But I do look up these scriptures that you give out.
Good.
And because to me, that's the most important thing. I love the scriptures that you share.
Mm-hmm.
So why is it so important, y'all, to actually enjoy digging into the Bible? And how does the podcast, your podcast, lend itself to supporting women and developing good daily Bible habits?
Yeah. For me, that verse in Proverbs 3:5, it says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. And to me, digging into the Word of God is how I don't lean on my own understanding.
Exactly.
I need Him. I need His wisdom. There's a lot of voices in the world, a lot of opinions.
Mm-hmm.
Wherever we look, there's somebody that wants to shout or share their opinion with us. And so just praying that the Lord's voice is the loudest one that I hear, and then digging into His Word where He speaks to us. That's so important. And so we hope to make it really simple to show that, you know, studying the Word of God, anybody can do that. You can do that. I know it's really intimidating when you begin, if you've not established that routine mm-hmm. yet, but we're praying that God uses our podcast to just show that, you know, if we can do it, you can do it.
Amen.
And just to provide some simple
things.
And one of the resources that we gave when we were doing a summer in the Psalms, and we really chose Psalms 119
mm-hmm.
because there was 176 verses, but they're actually broken down. We broke them in eight verses for each.
Yeah, it's broken into sections. Yeah. Yep.
And so we created a little a guide. Oh, yeah. Sure. And, you know, it's really kind of a roadmap. And mm-hmm. we're talking about the simplicity. Mm-hmm. We really overcomplicate scripture and we think, oh, I can't understand that. There are a lot of things in there, you know, we don't really have an answer to or go, well, I don't understand that. Yeah. But it doesn't mean that we quit.
We continue on the journey
and continue moving on. And one way to help us navigate that is answering some really basic and simple questions. Like you really just take a verse or a passage and you answer what word stood out to you. I mean, how simple is that?
Yeah.
What word has stood out to you? Then what verse stands out to you? And what does it say about God? Mm-hmm. And then another question is, what does it say about man? And sometimes it does, there's an answer to that, and sometimes there's not, to some of these anyway. And the last two questions you can ask yourself is, what truth can I stand on today, and how can you apply what you've learned? So it's really taking it that next level. Instead of just, you know, checking a box and reading God's Word, it's really taking in God's Word, owning it, letting it etch on our heart by asking some of these questions, and then going out in our life, in our walk, and applying what we've learned. Because it's so easy to just read something and go, oh, that was nice, and that was and it spoke to me, but we leave it there, and we don't take it with us when we close the Word and go to the next thing.
That's why I think memorizing scripture, just internalizing that scripture, is so important, because I can think of so many times that the Lord has brought a scripture to encourage me just in my mind, or to encourage another person. And if I had missed that time with Him, if I had not taken the time to memorize or study God's Word, I'd miss that opportunity and that blessing of God recalling that scripture in my heart and in my life. So that's just another really important reason to just get started. If you haven't started, just get started.
Just get started. Just
speaking of scripture, I'm mindful of 2 Timothy 3:16-17. Now this is the New International Version of that, but ultimately it's the word is to equip us for the work the Lord has for us too. It reads, all scripture is God breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness, so that the servant of God may be thoroughly equipped for every good work. I mean, that, you know?
Yes.
Set up.
Yes, I mean, we are so blessed to have this Bible.
Yeah.
We are so blessed to have His Word, because not only does it bring life, but it's a blueprint for living. I mean, He created each of us, so He knows how our heart is motivated, and He can bring out the best in us, you know, and it's Him that we surrender to at salvation. But it's just so, this daily Bible habit is just so important. I mean, we have to have fresh manna every day, don't we?
Yeah.
You know, because what you had before, the day before, that's, you know, even as the Israelites were walking in the desert, that's kind of spoiled. You can't, it's fresh every day. But He is that life giver, and that life that comes from the Word. I know many times in the past, where I had struggled with a tough situation or had been depressed, I would read the Word and I could almost feel that light coming from His Word, which was the peace, the joy, you know, the fruit of the Spirit. But it's in His Word. So praise God, we have the Bible.
Right. Well, you're making me think how often we'll read a scripture or a passage and we get an understanding from it and how to apply it, and then let's say a month, maybe even a year goes by, and you go back and you read something you know that you read, but you saw something in that scripture that you're like, how did that get in there? Did that change? Because I remember reading this and I don't remember that.
It goes back to the living and active scripture.
That's another example of that. And that happens so often when you're consistent in the Word.
It does. I mean, what the Word of God is living and active, sharper than any two-edged sword. And it does. It does that for us. And when we read the Bible reads us. You know, I've heard that too.
That's sweet.
It does. Yeah. I mean, and He ministers to us through His Word.
He does.
So How does, we talked about this a little bit, but how does memorizing and digging into scripture, it really helps us deepen our relationship with Jesus.
It does, Christ. It does. And, you know, Psalm 119:11 says, I've hidden your word in my heart that I might not sin against you. When you're filling your mind with the truth of God's word, there's going to be less space for anything else to take up. So, just the daily filling of God's word. And, you know, there have been times when I've struggled with the desire to read God's word.
Oh, sure.
I think we've all struggled with that sometime. But the Lord is so faithful that we can just come to him and say, Lord, I'm struggling. And he will meet us right where we are and give us that hunger and thirst again. But the important thing is to open up God's word. Just do it. Just do it. It doesn't have to be complicated. Just start somewhere, and he'll meet you there.
And God's word is truth. It is truth, and that truth guides us. But how are we going to be guided by truth if we're not in the truth? I think we talked a little bit. You mentioned delighting ourselves in the Lord. Mm-hmm. He gives us the desires of our heart, and really, what that means is that the more we delight in who God is, his ways and what he has done, really the nature, the attribute, the character of God, recognizing his holiness, his righteousness, that he's love, he is truth, he is light. Mm-hmm. The more that we get to know him, more we begin taking on that image, that character, that walk, that kind of life. Mm-hmm. And what delights him begins delighting us. Mm. And as we're, desires, what his desires are, we end up taking on his desires.
Yes.
And so delight yourself in the Lord, and he'll give you the desires of your heart, which now are the same as God's. And your desires are his will. You know, that makes sense?
I'm
going to do that up a little bit.
Yeah, you said it. That's just so true. I mean, and we're just so thankful for his word. We're so thankful that his word is fresh every day. His mercies are new every morning. And as we open it up, it does deepen our relationship with Jesus.
It's so relatable.
It is. To anyone. Okay, so how did the Bible come into being, and how can we know that it can totally be trusted as the inerrant word of God? Well, you do it by faith, of course, but there's a lot of information that this is the best-selling book of all times, but it has been supported throughout history and has been vetted throughout more than any other book. But tell us
we've talked a lot about that in our Questions That Need Answers series, so y'all check that out. That is, we went into depth about how the Lord is so faithful to preserve his word throughout all of history,
and it is a miracle. People died for printing the word,
and it's been tested over and over again and tried over and over again, and always is faithful and true, just like our Lord. It's his word. And so check that out, because we could spend hours discussing this.
And it's
wonderful, and it's such an important question to ask yourself, and to ask, you know, just to make sure you have those answers. So we talk a lot about that.
And if you want to find those, you can go online to the website or your favorite podcast app that you're using. And if you'll scroll to around September 9th of 2021, how did we get the Bible? We go into a deep dive into that and answer some questions. And then September 16th, 2021, how do we know the Bible is true? We once again go in more detail of that, and we would love for you to check that out. Not that we have all the answers.
No.
we even didn't answer it perfectly, but we answered it from God's word itself and some of the biblical history that we were able to research and context, and really take us on a journey through that. And there's just so much more. We can only really cover, if you will, a 5,000-foot view of what that looked like. But I believe that Carolyn and I were able to offer some a foundation for you to go deeper and to do some more digging and discovery for yourself.
Yeah, and I think that's our goal in every episode, that we provide resources so that you can study it for yourself see that truth for yourself.
We're kind of like the launching pad of these certain things.
It's really what we say does not matter. It doesn't matter. It's what the Word of God says. And
good.
So we want everybody to decide and discover that for themselves through the Word of God.
Yes, and I remember when they discovered the Dead Sea Scrolls in Israel in the cave in 1948. It was the book of Isaiah, which is one of the oldest books of the Bible, and it was almost word for word, 99.9% the very same, that it was preserved.
Mm-hmm.
So we know that the Word of God, even it has been revealed that it is so it's so accurate, and it has been preserved throughout the ages, miraculously by God's power.
Yeah,
and we're just really okay.
Yeah.
Well, oh goodness, and God uses flawed individuals like ourselves.
Yes, He does. Praise God.
Praise God.
Yes.
He uses.
Yeah.
I mean, you don't have to be perfect, but God used all these people to advance the kingdom.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Which is kind of neat and. Well, what's in the future? What's in the future for?
We've been praying over and discussing bringing the book of Hebrews, a study of Hebrews, probably a little bit like we did the summer in the Psalms with Psalms 119, and just going through that.
Just breaking it down.
So we're in the works of that, and that'll come after, most likely, a little bit after the Women Called series that we're doing.
Yeah.
So it's fun to have, you know, I mean, you guys are there almost every week, except for, Christmas and...
Right. Well, we do take a couple.
Yes, we'll take a break there. But it's just so neat to be able to be encouraged in the Word, and your podcast, people listen to it all over, even in other places in the world, and so it is global. It is global.
And
I hate that we have run out of time. We could talk about this a lot more, but we're running out of time. But, you know, Jodi, there could be somebody who out there who really doesn't know the Lord, and could you lead us all in a simple prayer of salvation?
Absolutely. I just want to invite you, if the Holy Spirit is just, there's something inside of you going, I desire to know God as my Savior and and to walk with Him the best that you can in your ability with His guidance. And I want to just lead you into a time of prayer. And there's nothing magical about the words. It's about the heart.
Right.
It's because we all have knowledge, a lot of us, not all, but have knowledge of God, but what about the heart condition? Mm-hmm. So if your heart is tugging, going, I want to know the Lord is my Savior, pray this simple prayer with me. Father God, I know I'm a sinner. I ask that you forgive me. I believe that Jesus Christ is your Son. I believed that He died for my sins and that you raised Him to life. I want to trust Him as my Savior and walk with Him as Lord of my life from this day forward. God, guide me and help me walk in your will and your way. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. God is so good.
Yeah.
He is so good. Well, I want to thank you girls for being my guests today, Jodi and Carolyn. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you for coming. Yeah. I really appreciate that. And thank you all for tuning in to Carolina Global Revival. I want to thank Nashcombe Realty, our sponsor. And remember, you are too blessed to be stressed. We'll see you real soon, and y'all have a great week.
Everyone needs compassion, a love that's never failing. Let mercy fall on me. Everyone needs forgiveness, the kindness of a Savior.